I received a text from somebody that said, did you hear about the church bombings in Egypt? And I thought, what is this? And I looked it up online, and I saw this just horrific news that our brothers and sisters, other Christians, were killed, and my heart just became so heavy. And so I stopped, and I prayed a real faithful prayer. And then a red bird flew over the back of my yard and landed in a tree. I looked over at the bird. Wow, cool bird. And forgot about everything that happened this fast. I immediately went back to my incredibly comfortable life, enjoying a beautiful Sunday afternoon by the pool. And some time went by before I realized that I'd forgotten about the tragedy. And suddenly I kind of awoke out of my stupor, and I was like, what in the world is wrong with me? Why don't we care like Jesus called us to care? Perhaps the most relevant and painful thought, if you're taking notes, is this. We're blessed and cursed with comfort. Because what's so difficult is the more comfortable our lives become, the more life tends to be about us and a little more of it. And before long, as Christians, we're actually trying to leverage God as the God who gets us what we want. So how do we overcome this incredibly repulsive attitude of apathy? Consistently expose yourself to something that creates a righteous discomfort. Any one of you who've ever been to a developing nation and you walked into just abject poverty, and then you want to give them everything you can to help them, and so you devote yourself to say, I'm going to care like I've never cared before. I'm not going to get upset about the things that upset me before, because it wrecks you in a really good way. But if you don't consistently expose yourself to that which moves your heart, the moment you get back, what happens? Life happens. Some things that you know break the heart of God, you're around it enough to where it starts to break your heart as well. No, I'm not okay with that. I know my God cares. I'm not gonna allow this to happen. Life is about pleasing God by using what he gave you to make a difference in this world. Some of you are moved deeply on behalf of the unborn. Some of you, it's racial injustice. Focus on those things. It's no accident that you are righteously angry about a few things on behalf of God, because God gave you those values to make a difference in this world. Embrace what hurts. If our version of Christianity is all about our comfort, if I never give sacrificially anywhere, I'm missing one of the greatest blessings in life. Because so many think blessings is more of the stuff we want. Every now and then, you just need to be blessed with a burden. Blessed with a burden. Blessed with a burden.